We're asked to solve the given equation using the construction and deconstruct story, also known as the story of the variable or the story of x. To begin, we'll write the steps that form the construction of the equation based upon the operations being performed on the variable b. Then we'll write the deconstruct story, which are the steps that will undo the construction of the equation and solve for the variable b. So to write the construction story, we begin with the variable b. Looking inside the parentheses, we have b divided by 2 minus 4. Remember, a fraction bar means division, and therefore the first step in the construction story is divide by 2. If we divide b by 2, this gives us the expression b divided by 2. Inside the parentheses, we now have minus 4, which means step 2 is subtract 4. So if we subtract 4 from this quotient, we now have the expression b divided by 2 minus 4. For step 3, notice how this difference is being multiplied by negative 3. Step 3 in the construction story is multiply by negative 3. If we multiply this difference by negative 3, we really have this difference times negative 3, but using the commutative property of multiplication, we can change the order of the product and write the product as negative 3 times the quantity b divided by 2 minus 4. Going back to the equation, we have equals 5, which means the result of performing these operations on the variable is 5. So the result is 5, which gives us the complete construction of the equation, which is negative 3 times the quantity b divided by 2 minus 4 equals 5. And our goal here is to deconstruct the equation and solve for b. To do this, we will reverse the order of these steps and perform the opposite or inverse operations. So because the last step in the construction story is multiply by negative 3, we need to undo this step as the first step in the deconstruction story, or deconstruct story. To undo multiplying by negative 3, we divide by negative 3, which is the first step in the deconstruct story. The previous step in the construction was subtract 4. To undo subtract 4, we need to add 4. So step 2 in the deconstruct story is add 4. And now we need to undo the first step in the construction story to get the last step, or third step, in the deconstruct story. To undo division by 2, we multiply by 2. Again, multiplying by 2 will undo or perform the opposite operation of dividing by 2. So these three steps will be the steps we perform on both sides of the given equation to get back to b, or to solve the equation for b. So beginning with the given equation, the first step is to divide both sides by negative 3. On the left, negative 3 divided by negative 3 simplifies to 1. The left simplifies to b divided by 2 minus 4. On the right, we have negative 5/3. The second step to solve for b is add 4 to both sides. On the left, minus 4 plus 4 simplifies to 0. We have b divided by 2 equals, let's find the sum down here. We have negative 5/3 plus 4, or plus 4 over 1. The least common denominator is 3. We multiply 4 over 1 by 3 over 3. This gives us negative 5/3 plus 12/3, which equals 7/3. So the right side of the equation is now equal to 7/3. The last step in the deconstruct story is multiply by 2. So now we multiply both sides of the equation by 2. We are changing the order of the multiplication here using the commutative property. And because both sides of the equation are in fraction form, we could write 2 as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Simplifying before multiplying, 2 divided by 2 simplifies to 1. 1 times b is b. On the right, nothing simplifies. We multiply the numerators and denominators, which gives us 14/3. So the solution to the given equation is 14/3. To verify this is the solution, we would need to substitute 14/3 for b in the original equation, then simplify the left side to verify it is equal to the right side of the equation, which is 5. I'll leave that check for you. I hope you found this helpful.